This is one safety valve. This is the inlet male threaded connection, and this is the outlet female threaded connection. This safety valve is having three parts. This is called body, angular body. This is called bonnet, and this is called cap. And this lever is testing lever. Now let us open the safety valve. Now I am opening body bonnet joint. This is the orifice, this, and this is actually inlet nozzle. So this is called inlet nozzle, and this is the orifice, and spring is there inside the bonnet. Due to the spring, this orifice is pressed by the disc. This is the disc. When operating pressure becomes more than the set pressure, then the disc is lifted and fluid flows through the outlet. Now this is the bonnet and this is the cap. Now I am opening bonnet and cap joint. So this is safety valve body, angular body. This is inlet and this is outlet. This is body bonnet joint. This is body. This is safety valve bonnet, and this is cover, and this is the spindle. This is the disc, and this is called disc guide. Due to this disc guide, this disc will be placed properly over the orifice. This is the orifice, and this is called inlet nozzle. This is the stem of the safety valve. This is the top attachment by which the stem of the safety valve can be lifted up for testing. And this is adjusting screw, and this is adjusting nut. With this adjusting screw and adjusting nut, this inside spring can be adjusted, can be tightened or can be loosened, and set pressure of the safety valve can be changed. Now I am opening this inside. To open this, this lock has to be removed. To open this, this lock has to be removed first. I am removing this lock. This is a ring, and this is the lock. Now this is the spindle of the safety valve. This top plate is called spring top plate, and this bottom plate is called spring bottom plate. And this is disc guide. Through this guide, this disc sits over the nozzle properly. Inside the safety valve, this spring is pressed like this, spaced, and at pressed condition, this disc actually sits over the orifice or inlet nozzle like this. And when operating pressure inside the safety valve process the set pressure, then this disc is lifted up and fluid flows through the outlet. Now this is the adjusting screw. I am opening the adjusting screw. Actually, this adjusting screw can be adjusted by this nut, and safety valve spring can be adjusted, or spring load can be adjusted, and set pressure can be changed. This is testing lever of the safety valve. It is having one mechanism inside like this. With this mechanism, this top nut can be lifted up like this. So when we want to test the safety valve, whether safety valve is working or not, then we rotate this lever and then safety valve pops, and we will be sure that safety valve is okay and working. If the safety valve is of carbon steel, then this angular body, bonnet and cap and this lever is of carbon steel. ASTM A216 grade WCV, and internals, that means this stem, this upper spring washer or plate, lower spring plate, this guide plate, this disc and this nozzle and orifice, this adjusting screw, everything is of stainless steel, and spring is of stainless steel or of Inconel. If the safety valve is of stainless steel, then this body, bonnet, cap, lever and all internals, everything is of stainless steel. This is the orifice. When safety valve will pop, then reaction force will be this orifice area into set pressure of this safety valve, and that reaction force will act in this direction. This is the blow off direction, and reaction force will act in opposite direction like this. Now I am assembling the safety valve set. This is the body, this is the gasket, and this is the guide plate. Then this is the body bonnet joint. I am tightening the body bonnet joint like this. Then this is the adjusting screw. I am tightening the adjusting screw like this. Now spring is getting pressed due to tightening of this adjusting screw like this. And this is the nut. With this nut we can change the spring load, that means we can change set pressure of the safety valve. Then I am mounting the top nut. This is top nut for lifting safety valve, and this is the pin. I am mounting the pin. Then this is the lock, so that pin will not be able to come out. So this is the arrangement. Now I will provide the cover. and this is the inlet nozzle. I am mounting the inlet nozzle again. So this is the entire assembly of safety valve. Now the spring is facing the disc and disc is facing the nozzle or orifice. As per API 520, every safety valve should be provided with this type of lifting lever or testing lever. The purpose of this testing lever is to test the safety valve periodically by doing this. When we do this, then the stem raised up, disc raised up, and safety valve pops at 75% of set pressure. By doing this, we will be able to know that the safety valve is operable and any accumulated debris inside the safety valve will go out.